So obviously you guys are banking on the fact that Tim Bradley, he may not be as disciplined and he may end up, you know, fighting toe-to-toe some point in this fight. What if he doesn't do that? Does it just completely favor him, the fight, if he doesn't do that?
Look, everybody thinks that Bradley is a boxer like a Mayweather or those type of guys that are very difficult, like Lara, you know. He's not. He could box, but he's not a fighter, a defensive fighter like a Mayweather. So Mayweather could fight for 12 rounds and win his fights by decision. Timothy Bradley can't. He can't. You know, Brandon's been in against good boxers that try to box, but Brandon, you know, makes them fight because of Brandon's style. Timothy Bradley is gonna try, but believe me, he's not gonna be able to do it for 12 rounds.
Now, you were just saying just previously that you don't believe Teddy Atlas really made that much of a change in Tim Bradley's style because he's been boxing for so long. Elaborate on that. Is that how you feel?
Look, what he said was, you know, he got rid of a lot of people to save money, 10% on management, 10% on trainers. So he probably, I don't know how much he's paying Teddy Atlas, maybe 2 or 3%. Yeah, that's what, you know, he could have saved it all and have his dad train him and give his dad the money, because Timothy Bradley is Timothy Bradley with Atlas, with Joel, with his dad, with whoever. Timothy Bradley is Timothy Bradley. He's very talented and he's always gonna be the same Timothy Bradley, you know, that we've always seen.
Is Tim Bradley the same fighter before, like the Diego Chavez and the Jesse Vargas fight? You think he's the same fighter, Tim?
No, we don't want to. I want to focus. We're focused on the Bradley that dominated the welterweight division. The Bradley that beat Marquez in a very good performance. That's what we're training for. We're not training for the Bradley who took a beating against Provonikov, or the Bradley who almost went down against Vargas. We're focused on the best Bradley out there.
Okay. Everyone stereotypes Brandon Rios as having just this one style. He's one dimensional. Do you want him to show any type of versatility at all in his career? Or you prefer him to just fight, you know?
Brandon has to fight. Brandon, you know, everybody in boxing always says, oh, Brandon, you know, even after this fight, we, you know, even if we're to win this fight, people are still going to rank Brandon, you know, 17, 18, 20 in the best welterweights, because that's just the way it's always going to be with Brandon. Brandon is always gets in with everything. Brandon actually blocks most, you know, a lot of punches. You know,
everybody, he got a good jab, too.
Who doesn't get hit? He has a good jab. You know, Brandon's very strong, not only physically, but mentally. So, you know, those are things that I have got him to where he's at. You know, he became world champion. He's got some great wins, great fights, great wars that people always enjoy. And this one's going to be another one.